Hello amazing people, Jagrat this side. So in the previous video, we saw some new different coding problem like remove word from the string. So in this video, we are going to variation from the previous problem. So this time, we will remove numbers from the string. So let us suppose we have this input given, that is 1, 2 or something like this. So we need to remove all the numbers from this string and the output should be like this. So again, let's talk about the approach. So what are the approaches to solve this particular coding problem? So we have basically again two approaches. So the first is using inbuilt method and second is without inbuilt method. So let's firstly talk about the inbuilt method. So let me create a method for this. So public static void, and I will say like remove number from string. Okay. And here I will pass the string here. Okay. This thing. Now, again the same thing, as I told you that there is a inbuilt method replace all. So I will use the same method here. So string dot replace all. Okay, so here we need to give the regular expression. So if you want to remove the numbers from this, so we can use this regular expression. This consists of, you know, all the digits, and here we need to replace it with the empty string. Okay, so this is the thing. Now I need to, I can directly like print this. So system.out.println, and here I will pass this thing. So let me copy this and let me paste it like this. Okay. So with the help of this, we can directly replace all digits with the this empty string. Okay. So let me call this particular method here and let's see whether it is working fine or not. So let me copy this string and let me paste here. And let's run this program. So you can see guys, we achieved our expected output. So in the output, all numbers are removed. So this is the method. With the help of this inbuilt method, that is the replace all, we need to give the regular expression that we need to replace all the digits with the empty string. Okay. So this is the first approach. Now let's talk about the second approach, that is the without inbuilt method. So let me create a new method. So now we are going to talk about the second approach. Okay. So what would be our approach in this case? So the thing is like, how can we proceed? How can we remove all the numbers if we don't want to use the inbuilt method? So what we will do, that of course the same thing, that we need to store our output in a different string. And after that, we will apply the for loop. Okay. We will apply the for loop. And wherever we can say wherever the number is there, we will skip that. And rest of the thing, I mean, rest of the places, we can copy into this requested or required string variable. Okay, so let's implement and let's see whether it is working fine or not. So this is my approach. Maybe we can change our approach later, but if it is working fine, then we will follow this approach. Okay, so for let's do one thing. Because this is the string, so firstly what we will do, we will convert it into the character array. Okay, so that every we can get each and every character from this string. Okay, so this is something like this. I have already told you what is the function, toCar array. So there is a function that is toCar array, which is fine. Now I will apply the for loop. So int I is equal to 0, I is less than ch dot length and I plus plus. Okay, and here we will apply the condition. So if you want to apply the condition, then there can be again two approaches. First is you can use the ASCII code value, but that is very layman approach and that is not recommendable because it is very hard to learn the ASCII values of the characters. So there is a class that is character class. Okay, so this is a character class. You can see that, let me show you. And you can see different types of method is there. Is alphabetic, is defined, is digit. So lots of methods are here. Okay, so we will check that if character is digit. Okay, and here I will pass ch of I, simple. So what we are going to check, we are going to implement that if character is not digit, then we will print all the letters into this required variable, string variable. Okay, because we need to negate this. So that's why I will incorporate this negation sign. So the whole concept is like we are skipping the digits. Okay. So let's implement this and let's see whether it is fine or not. So request is equal to req plus ch of I. Okay. And what we will do, we will print this. So we can write like this, that required string is and we will print this variable. So this is the approach. So you need to remember a new concept here, that there is a character class. Okay, with the help of this character class, we can check whether any particular digit or character. So there are different types of inbuilt method that are present in this character class. Okay, so now let's run this and let's see whether it is working fine or not. So what is this method? This method is this. Okay, so simply run this program and let's see whether it is working fine or not. Yes, it is working fine. You can see that we achieved our output. So this is the approach that we can follow if we don't want to use the inbuilt method. Okay. Now again the same variation, like let us suppose I don't want to convert our string into the character array, then what we need to do, let me copy the whole thing. And let me give the name as 2. So this time we don't want to use this. We don't want to convert our string into the character array. So the simple change is like we can directly use this as a string. So str dot length. Okay. And here, as I told you, that there is a method like str dot caret. Okay, and this is the index, and here I will also use str dot caret index. That's it. This is only the change that we can follow. Okay, what is the problem here? I think yes, now it is fine. Okay, there is some problem of parenthesis, closing parenthesis. Okay, so this is the simple thing that we can follow. Now let's run this method and let's see whether it is working fine or not. So let me run this and see, we achieved our expected output. So this is again the different variation of, you know, some remove number from the string. So this is the new coding problem that I told you the both approaches, like using the inbuilt method or without inbuilt method. So please practice this, and that's all for this session. So in the upcoming session I will come with some new coding problem. So hope it makes sense, and thank you. Bye bye.